I also took into account that I've been involved in the case for 7 years, and I've observed how the case has developed and how the parties have developed over the course of time. Based upon these circumstances, the court does not find that there is clear and convincing evidence that Anissa Wire poses a significant threat of bodily harm to herself or others or of serious property damage. On that basis, then, I'll grant the petition for conditional release. I'll order that the release is granted under section 971.17 sub 4 sub D. As part of that, I'll order that the Department of Health Services prepare the necessary conditional release plan and submit it to the court within 60 days. So that's my order today. We'll set a hearing within 60 days, which is August 30th. So if we can fit it in, we'll fit it in for about an hour. Now that's past the 60 days. Is there any objection to doing it?
I asked Ms. Wire and she's not objecting to that.
Any objection from the state?
No.
Okay, well, that'll be our next court hearing. That would be September 10th. At what time?
At 9 a.m.
At 9 a.m. That'll be the next hearing. We'll issue the necessary orders to the Department of Health Services to proceed. With that, then, I'll order that Ms. Wire returns into the Winnebago Mental Health Institute pending further court proceedings. I'll remand her then to the custody of the sheriff to be transported back to the institution. Anything further from the state?
No, thank you.
Anything further from the defense?
No, Your Honor, thank you.
All right, thank you. Then good luck to everybody. Have a good day. Dr. Pope, as well as Ms. Andrews, thank you for being here. Court is in recess.